Up next, the ghosts of Yorkville. After 30 years, the Ugly Ducklings make a comeback.
You remember the Ugly Ducklings? They were a bad boys band from Cedarbrae Collegiate in Scarborough, and they took Yorkville by storm in the mid-1960s. During those heady days, they played in the company of Jimi Hendrix and Wilson Pickett and the Animals, and they opened for the Rolling Stones in 1966, Mick Jagger declaring them his favorite Canadian band. In spite of numerous fights and breakups over the years, they just can't seem to stay apart. This year, they're releasing the first collection of all original material in more than 30 years. It's called Snafu.
You know, if you told me in 1967 that the Ducks would be recording an album in 2001, I would have said that you're off your rocker.
No. Oh, Dave.
You would have, too.
No, I wouldn't.
You would have, too.
No, I wouldn't.
Well, it's sort of like, you know, we would have thought, well, geez, I'd be too old and gray and decrepit to still be playing rock and roll. Well, you're lucky you still got your hair, you know.
I think the great triumph of the Ducklings is that they have outlasted all of those naysayers and skeptics and conservative record industry people. They're still around today.
I'm here, baby, I'm saying, you're driving me insane. You're driving me mad, yeah, you're rattling my brain. I happen to mention what you said last night. You paid no attention, you just dropped out of sight. Baby, you know I need nothing.
We were in the folk club and we were the only guys who didn't play any folk.
Yeah. We wanted the electric instruments. It had to be loud, you know? That was the time of the Beatles and the Stones, and people were watching on TV, and the girls were especially watching, and they saw that this is what you do when a band plays, you scream. So all the girls screamed and everything, and we thought it was great. We all sat down and we said, gee, wouldn't it be fun to just do this, like, for a living? And that's when we sort of made the decision that we were gonna try and be professional.
Get paid.
And get money for it. Why don't we go back to the beginning?
I wanted to record these guys because I think they still got, you know, great songs. And you don't stop being a rock and roll artist. You don't stop being an artist, period. You know, you've got a muse and you've got a reason to let these things out. So, and I think it's important. I think it's important from a Canadian cultural point of view, but I think it's really important just strictly from a, you know, music point of view.
When we first started off, we were just winging it. You know, Roger was winging it, playing his leads, and I was winging it, singing. We were all just winging it. We didn't have a clue what we were doing. So now that we've got a little bit of knowledge, not too much, it just sort of puts a little, we're still gritty, but there's a better edge there.
Yeah.
You know, it's tighter. This album is really going to amaze people because it's a lot tighter than what we used to be.
Ooh, that girl, could she be part of my world?
Roger and I made a real effort to try and make the lyrics consistent with what we used to be.
In the attitude.
In the attitude. Now we've sort of...
Our thing was songwriting, and we didn't really prepare to write songs. We just played. Now we're writing songs again, and
we're trying to make them...
And we know how to make the sounds that make our music come alive. And I think that's the secret. We've kind of figured out the formula now. Took us a while. Took us like 30
years.
This
is, but I think we've sort of recaptured a lot of what we used to be about in the 60s.
The Ducklings were probably the loudest, the rawest, the noisiest band with the longest hair, and they had the dirtiest, grittiest sound of all the bands in Yorkville.
The recording industry didn't want to deal with us way back. They didn't like us because we were unmanageable.
We were hard
to deal with. We were independent, and we wouldn't listen to them. They thought our songs were shit most of the time, you know. So
yeah.
you know, we just did our own thing, and we wouldn't be conformed to, like, be a pop band, per se. Well, the ironic thing is that we're the band that everybody remembers from then.
They don't know what to do with us. Where do we fit in?
We've never fit in, so, I mean, we're just doing it the same way. I think that after people hear this album, they may want to know about us again, but we'll see. That could be famous last words, too.
Yeah.